Dante Zagratis bothers me. He bothers me a lot. And, like, not just because of how creepy his body magic looks when he uses it, but just how his character just is bothers me. Because I feel like he really has some stuff there for him to be a really good character. But it's just the way he was handled was so very odd to me. Like, I feel like it went in a very weird direction. And now, this isn't to, like, take away from anybody who has Dante as one of their favorite villains, or if you like Dante just as a character or how he is, this isn't to take away from that, because if that's your favorite character, if you just like him, no one can take that from you. That's your opinion. This is my opinion. So, you know, we can all have our opinions and it's all right. It's gonna be okay. But the thing with Dante is, no matter how cool he may seem to be on the surface, or how dope his character may seem to be on the surface, I feel like there's no denying that certain bits of his character, or like a lot of his character elements, were left really shallow for some reason. And it's funny because it's like there's so many times where I feel like we touch the very surface of how deep Dante could be, but then it never like fully goes all the way in. Or he just has like a couple few things that are just like missing from him being like a really dope villain. And before I get like way more into it, is I if you're anime only, I'm gonna just let you know now, we're spoiling the manga here. The manga is getting spoiled. So if you don't care about that, you know, stick around. But if not, get out of here. Get out of here.
Why are you still here?
Now, one thing that I want to say is, whether a lot of people like it or not, for the better half of the Spade Assault arc, for like the majority of the Spade arc, Dante has been portrayed as the main villain. And what that means is basically, like, no matter who you think the main villain actually is, or who the main villain may actually turn out to be, the fact still remains that Dante was presented to us in this arc as the major villain. Like, I feel like you can't really argue that, in my opinion. Because, like, whether you think it's Morris in the end, or Lucifaro in the end, or Lucifugus in the end, whoever you think may end up double crossing or backstabbing who to be whoever, it was presented to us as Dante when initially, when we were preparing in the 6 month time skip for the Dark Triad and their devils. It was like when we first come back after Asta claps the base, I want to say it's like chapter 231 or something, when we get to see him, Dante is portrayed as, you know, that king of the Spade Kingdom, they're like leader, so to speak. So with that position, I feel like the position of the leader of the next villain group, you should have certain things that go along with you to make yourself a really great villain. And I feel like there's just a couple things that Dante is lacking. Now, I will say what I like about Dante is he has a good personality of a villain, in terms of just how, like, how he's very confident in himself. He has that overwhelming power to him, and that overwhelming presence, and all of that, which I feel like is very important for a villain. I feel like if you are going to be a main villain, or just a good villain, not even a main one, but just a good villain, is I feel like that just untouchableness of being like not unbeatable, but they just seem like they'd be a challenge to defeat in the story is very important, because the villain should feel threatening. You know, they just feel like, oh my gosh, if this person drops down, it's a really big deal. And that's how it was when Dante first dropped down against the Black Bulls base. He was a very big deal. Like, nothing they were doing was working. Asta couldn't do anything to him at all. He was a very big deal. But one of the major things that kind of shook that up was Dante actually losing in that encounter in the very end. Granted, it was at the extreme difficulty of a Yami and Asta post Asta crazy power up team up, but he still lost, which kind of broke that unbeatable, you know, what kind of broke that like unbeatable image that a lot of main villains seemed to maintain for much longer. Because from Dante's introduction to when he got beat, or not introduction, but from Dante beginning the fight to where he lost, wasn't really that much. Like, it wasn't that long of a time period, especially in story. It was the exact same day, so it's like he wasn't a threat for that long. And granted, it's not like he died, or it's not, you know, Yami still got captured in the end, so the main goal was still accomplished, but his major villain presence was already shattered. So I feel like that's kind of like one notch that was definitely against him. And then from a, you know, a character development, or from like a just a character standpoint, he felt really shallow. Because I know one big popular thing to say is that Dante's reason for being evil is he's evil just to be evil. I've even said this, but I feel like saying that is kind of disingenuous, because he does have a reason to be evil. Like, he does, like, to say he just doesn't have anything, I would be lying. We did get that one page or one panel, or that very short section when he was talking to Yami about how, like, you know, nothing would satisfy his malice, so that's why he kind of went down the path that he did, which is, you know, we got to see various parts, you know, nothing really satisfied him, you know, be it like sex, money, military accomplishments, all that stuff. Nothing really did it for him. So like, you know, turning to the more darker side of the emotions is what brought him to where he is now. The world was too dull. It was too boring for him. So like, he does have a reason. It's just that like, why he's like this, it's one of those things where like, you can, I feel like as a villain, you can get a pass on lacking in certain elements as long as you make up for him in other ones. So it was like him having a somewhat shallowish backstory or motives for why he was the way he was at that moment kind of made up for it because of how overwhelming and intimidating he was. And kind of like how his ideals directly clashed against how Asta's worked, whereas like Dante thought it was all of the darker emotions and darker feelings that made you more human, that like truly made you feel alive, versus when Asta was like, you know, it's overcoming these emotions that make you more human. So like their like idealistic clash was there, but it kind of started to all fall apart in my opinion once Dante lost. Like I feel like that's when a lot of people kind of just felt really meh about him. And then he was built up again, you know, he was in the freaking healing fluid. He was like Vegeta on Namek, like getting ready for his next fight. Morris had made adjustments. He was seeming even more threatening, you know, when he was going up against Jack and knocked. And then he's beaten, you know, later in that fight, you know, after, you know, he powers up to 100% and all that, he's beaten later by Magna, which like, I feel like really hurts him. Like, I feel like it was a big up for Magna, but a big lower for Dante, because it's like, Dante as a villain was supposed to, or at least he was portrayed to be so much. And it's like, we didn't get much for him in terms of his backstory, in terms of his motives, and his unbeatable, like, you know, persona as being a big bad was kind of like really, really shattered by losing again. Not the fact that it was Magna, but the fact that he lost again. So it's like, it's kind of hard to be really intimidated by Dante. And it's funny because like him losing is definitely a result of his own personality, which shows that, you know, he is a consistent character. Like Dante in himself is extremely overconfident in his body magic. He takes a lot of pride in the fact that he is a devil host that will boost his body magic to crazy amounts. So like him losing makes sense. It's not like Dante being a bad character on that note, but it's just like it definitely took away from, you know, how he, I felt like, was viewed by the fandom. Because I feel like there are lots of things that make a really good villain. Like, I mean, if you look at like anime and manga and you want to talk about like amazing villains, like villains that like across the board everyone will say is an amazing top tier villain, like a lot of people will say like Aizen, you know. And it's like, what does Aizen have that Dante doesn't? And it's like, well, you know, Aizen had this huge master plan. He was around for a really long time. He was extremely powerful. Like he had all this stuff going for him. But if you look at it, in my personal opinion, I feel like Aizen's motive kind of lacked a little bit. That's just me. And maybe you might think that too, but since he had all this other stuff going for him, it didn't matter. Or if you look at like Pain from like an idealistic standpoint was so different from Naruto, despite, you know, them having similar views, which is how they went about them being kind of different, which is a really good twist. Like Pain felt justified. That's another thing is true about Aizen. He felt justified. And I feel like a villain feeling justified in their own actions is a really dope thing. Whereas like Dante knew he was being wrong and just didn't care. So it's like he didn't have any air of like, he just didn't have that like extra oomph when you compare him to that. And like, I'm not even saying that like a villain has to be justified in their actions or they have to feel like they're doing the correct thing, because you could even look at another villain, like take like freaking Doflamingo from One Piece. Like Doffy never thought he was a good guy. Like Doffy never thought what he was doing was justified. He just didn't care. And like that's another, I feel like, type of villain that you can be, the kind that just don't care. But whereas you could say that like Doflamingo's motives weren't that great, if you look at his backstory, if you look at like his backstory on why he's the way he is and his childhood and how he was raised, it all makes perfect sense, which, you know, kind of all comes together to make him a really great villain, especially with how overwhelmingly powerful he was in that exact moment in his arc on Dressrosa. So it's like it made a lot of sense there. Like he had a lot of things going for him that was really held together by having a super tight, amazing backstory, whereas Dante didn't really have that. So it's one of those things that when you look at like amazing top tier villains, they have a lot more things going for them and are solid in a lot more parts than Dante does, which is a little unfortunate. Whereas to say Dante doesn't have these elements is false, but it's just like his overwhelming presence. You got beaten twice, you know, relatively close together, so that hurts that. Your backstory and motives together are really shallow, so that really does hurt you in the long run, I feel like, as being a dope villain. And Again, like I said in the beginning, if Dante is your favorite character, that's fine. Like, body magic along with gravity magic is dope. It's a really dope combination. But it's just really crazy to see, like, how far Dante did fall from when we first got to see him to now. And, as of the recording of this video, like, I don't even know if Dante is still alive. Because, as you know, some people say Jack probably killed him. Some people say since we didn't see him die, he might come back. And honestly, it's almost too late for Dante, in my opinion. Even if Dante does come back, you know, later on in this story, and is like, they flesh out his character more and give him more motives, it's almost too late for him. It's almost too late. Like, he missed out on a lot of opportunities to have some dope backstory added in, or more motivation, or stuff like that. So, I mean, it might just be too late for Dante's character, unfortunately, which is actually really tragic, honestly. Honestly, I could go off on the whole Dark Triad, but today I just really wanted to talk about Dante in particular. I am curious to know you guys' thoughts on the matter of Dante kind of being like a tragic character. Are you like a big fan of Dante? Do you like him a lot? Or are you just somebody who like really hates him? Like, do you really just hate how Dante is? Or do you like really just dislike how he was as a character? Because, like, honestly, I don't think Dante is a bad character. Like, I don't think him as a character in a story is bad. I just think, like, he just was really shallow. I feel like he was shallow and, like, kind of just, like, very shortly ran. And it may play into the bigger grand scheme of things, but for the purpose in the story he was supposed to serve in that moment, it didn't work for me personally. But like I was saying, opinions, everybody has them. So let me know how you guys feel about it down below in the comment section. I would love to hear you guys' opinions on this kind of thing. Make sure you guys like the video as well as subscribe to the channel. With that, I have nothing else for you guys. You guys enjoy the rest of your day, and I will see you all in my next video.